The people who ended up saying yes always said yes, maybe in the first meeting. So I found people didn't fundamentally change their mind on us. If they said, I'm probably not interested in this in the first meeting, none of those people ended up investing, even if they took a second meeting. So for myself as an entrepreneur, I learned that it is hard for people to part with their money. And if someone doesn't have an initial reaction that maybe this could work, then they probably will never reach that. Now, of the people who said maybe this would work, not all of them invested, but most of them did. So I think that first observation of you have to find someone who has an interest, a belief, and for whom your story is resonating. And if you don't have those things, then nothing else is going to matter. There was a path where I could have raised $500,000 and built a certain company at a certain rate, and I could have raised $2 million and tried to build a different company at a different rate. It has to do with a little bit of the style and the way in which you want to build the company. So for me, I thought about how much of the company am I willing to give away? How much do I think it will really take to get to prove something that's a good enough product that I'll be able to achieve a higher valuation? And what's the amount of money I need to raise to not be constantly anxious and worrying about money? And by thinking about those points for me as an entrepreneur and for our business, which is a software mobile-based business, that was how I thought about how much money to raise.